Students, in part 6 of this chapter, today we learn how to construct a parallelogram with given measurements. Construct the parallelogram PQRS with PQ 4.5 cm, QR 3 cm, angle PQR 60 degrees. As we know that to construct a quadrilateral, we need 5 independent measurements. But we have only 3 here. What about the other 2 measurements? Now let's recall the properties of parallelogram. Since opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal, the side opposite to PQ is RS, so which is equal to 4.5 cm, and the side opposite to QR is SP, which is 3 cm. Now we got it all the 5. So using these 5 measurements, let us construct a parallelogram. Before that, we draw the rough figure. They given here PQ 4.5 cm, QR 3 cm, angle PQR is 60 degrees. So here, the measure of angle Q they given 60 degrees. So we know that we have to take the base which includes this angle. This Q we have in PQ line segment and also in QR. So we can take anyone as base. Now let's take PQ as base. Rough figure it is. First you take PQ 4.5 cm. At Q we have to construct 60 degrees angle. So draw using compass we have to construct. But as it is rough figure, just you draw QX ray such that angle XQP is 60 degrees. Next we have to construct with Q as center 3 cm radius, draw an arc which intersects QX ray at R. Next we have to construct with R as center taking 4.5 cm radius, again you draw an arc. With P as center, 3 cm radius, you cut this previous arc. Children, when it is 4.5 cm, the opposite side also 4.5. And here, these two are opposite sides, they are equal. Now, these two arcs intersect at S. We have to join RS and PS. So this is your parallelogram. Now we'll construct the main figure now. Take the ruler and compass. First what we have to construct children, PQ 4.5 cm. Now place the scale. Mark your starting point at 0. Ending point at 4.5. So 4 after 5th line. This is your end point. Join the two points. So we get the line segment of 4.5 cm length. Name PQ 4.5 cm. Now we have to construct 60 degrees angle using compass. Now place your needle end at Q, take some convenient radius, draw an arc. Where this arc intersects on the line segment, from there you draw another arc. Now join the intersecting point of two arcs from Q. Name this ray as QX, which measures here 60 degrees. Next what we have to do with Q as center, taking 3 cm radius. So take starting point at 0, ending point at 3. Take this radius length which is 3 cm. With Q as center, cut this QX ray which intersects at R. name this point as R. Next, what we have to do with R as center, taking 4.5 centimeters radius, we have to draw another arc. So starting point at 0, ending point at 4.5, 4 after 5th line. Now take this radius, 4.5 centimeters, place your needle end at R and draw an arc. Now with P as center, taking 3 centimeters radius, we have to cut this arc. Children, already we have here 3 centimeters, let us take. Place your needle end at P and cut this arc. These two arcs intersects at S. Name this point as S. Now we have to join RS and SP. Write the lengths here. This is 3 centimeters, this is 4.5 centimeters, this is 3 centimeters. This is your required parallel. Now you see the steps of construction. First, we have to draw PQ 4.5 centimeters. Using compass, we have to construct XQP. Angle XQP is 60 degrees. With Q as center, taking 3 centimeters radius, we have to draw an arc which intersects this QX ray at R. This is your third point. Next, what we done? Taking R as center, radius 4.5 centimeters, we have to draw an arc. Again with P as center, taking 3 centimeters radius, we have to draw an arc which intersects the previous arc at S. Next, we done, we joined PS and RS. So required parallelogram PQRS is constructed. If you want to check by using scale, you can measure the lengths, children. This is 4.5. The same length we have opposite side also, we have the same length, which is 4.5. And here 3 centimeters. The same length we have here, which is 3 centimeters. So which satisfied the properties. Opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. If you want to check this angle, take protractor. See, exactly we have 60 degrees. So we done the perfect construction. Next, let us construct rhombus. Construct a rhombus MATH with 84 centimeters, angle MAT is 120 degrees. We need 5 measurements, but here they given only 2. Then what about the other 3? Let's recall the properties of rhombus. Since adjacent sides of a rhombus are equal, it means all sides are equal, the length of MAT, TH, MH, all the sides are equal to 4 centimeters. So let us construct now. First, we construct the rough figure. What we have to take? Take AT as base, which is 4 centimeters. Here angle MAT is 120 degrees. So at A we have to construct 120 degrees. So draw AX ray such that angle XAT is 120 degrees. Next, we have to construct MA 4 centimeters. With A as center, 4 centimeters radius, draw an arc which intersects AX ray at M. As we know that all sides are equal, with M as center, again the same 4 centimeters radius, you draw an arc. Again, taking 4 centimeters radius, we will cut this arc which intersects at H. Then we join MH and HT. See how easy, children, since all sides are equal. Now let's do the main construction here using the rough figure. First construct 84 centimeters. Starting point is at 0, ending point is at 4. Join. Name 84 centimeters. Now how to construct 120 degrees at A. Now take again some convenient radius. Placing A as center, draw an arc. Children, don't disturb the radius. Where this arc intersects, from there you draw one arc, which is 60. Again, with same radius where this arc intersects, draw another arc. Now here, join this. This is your 120 degrees. Name it X. Angle X A T 120 degrees. Next, what we have to do? We have to take 4 centimeters radius again. Starting point this is, ending point here. Take 4 centimeters radius. Placing your needle end at A. Cut this AX ray which intersects at M. For rhombus, very easy children. With the same radius, we will draw the arcs. With M as center, draw an arc with 4 centimeters radius. Again, with the same radius, you cut this arc. Since these two arcs are not intersected, so go back to the point M and extend the arc. Now, intersected here. Where these two arcs intersect, you name it as H. Now join MH and HT. See how easy, children. With one radius, we can complete this rhombus. 4 centimeters, 4 centimeters, and here also we have 4 centimeters. Now you see the steps of construction. First, draw 84 centimeters. Using compass, construct X, angle X AT is 120 degrees. With A as center, taking 4 centimeters radius, we have to draw an arc which intersects this AX ray at M. Next, what we done? With M and T as centers, taking 4 centimeters radius, we have to draw 2 arcs which intersects at H. Next, we have to join TH and MH. So, required rhombus math is constructed. See how easy, children, rhombus. Since all the sides are equal, easily we constructed. So, I hope you understand the construction of parallelogram and rhombus. Practice the same sums and construct accurate figure. Don't do any adjustments in the figure. And immediately after construction, you measure and see, children. See, 84 centimeters and MA also 4 centimeters, MH 4 centimeters and HT also 4 centimeters. So, angle also you have to measure by using protractor. See, exactly we have 120 degrees. I hope you understand. With this, I conclude my class. Do same, the two sums, whatever I explained, do as assignment. Thank you.